So really, the number one priority for agencies is assisting their clients. They want to make sure that the premiums and the exposures match. Businesses like to brag on themselves. Most all businesses at least have a Facebook page, if not a website. So going to those pages, looking at pictures, it gives us different questions to ask. And it enables the agent to be able to classify that business a little bit better. Even with all that research and work, there are still several classes that most insurance carriers will say are really hard to write. One of those is the Executive Supervisor Class 5606. Most all construction companies want to be able to have that for their supervisory staff. However, the scope of this classification is very, very clear. There must be a layer of supervision between the person that's classed as 5606 and the person that's actually doing the labor. Many policyholders come to us and say, but my foreman, he's the one doing the supervising and he doesn't sling a hammer. Therefore, we believe that he should be classified in 5606 Executive Supervisor. I understand, but unfortunately, the NCCI scopes tells us that we have to have that layer of supervision in between there. Another code that tends to give us some trouble is 5437, Trim Carpentry. This is a specialty code which specifically applies to those contractors who are only performing trim, installation, or cabinet installation. If there is any other carpentry job occurring on the job site, then we have to go ahead and place those operations in the bigger carpentry class code. So for example, if they're performing residential construction, it's going to be classed in 5645. If we're performing commercial construction, it's going to go in 5403. So the only time a contractor could legitimately use the code 5437 is when they are only performing trim carpentry, and that is the only construction that's going on at the job site. Of course, we also have to talk about our standard exception codes of 8810 clerical and 8742 outside sales. So many times we have policyholders that believe that since they are doing part of their work in an office or doing outside sales, that they're going to qualify for these codes. However, as standard exceptions, NCCI tells us that we can either only classify someone who is clerical if they are only performing clerical, and if they have any other job duty, then that excludes them from that class code. The same thing occurs with outside sales. You're either all sales or nothing at all. NCCI does offer online access to their manuals, and that provides a thorough description of all these class codes, so it's wonderful to be able to go there and do that research. And of course, MEM is always open for you to call and ask us, and we are happy to walk through those classifications with you.